Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum students. We continue our discussion on the topic of microbiology. Our today's topic of discussion is classification of bacteria. Students, before proceeding to this topic, it's better I tell you that there is a slight difference between classification of bacteria and identification of bacteria. Classification of bacteria is done on the basis of different characteristics, while on the other hand, identification is mostly done on the basis of different biochemical reactions or biochemical properties which the bacteria show. Unless the examiner asks specifically, for practical purposes, classification of bacteria is carried out on the following scenarios, which I am telling you today. Classification of bacteria. Students, what are the criteria for classifying bacteria? Number one, most important, morphology. Morphology means shape of the bacteria. Okay? Number two criteria, staining technique. Number third criteria, students, nutrition. Number four, oxygen requirements. Number five, anatomic. Number six, temperature. Okay, students? Number six, temperature. Number seven, culture. These are common seven criterions for classifying bacteria. We discuss today one by one. आप नजदीक हो जाओ जी स्टूडेंट्स. नंबर वन क्राइटेरिया फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन इज मॉर्फोलॉजी. स्टूडेंट्स, मॉर्फोलॉजिकली बैक्टीरिया आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री मेन कैटेगरीज. नंबर वन कोकाई, नंबर बी बेसिलाई, एंड नंबर सी स्पायरोशीज. कोकाई बैक्टीरिया, दीज आर राउंड शेप्ड बैक्टीरिया, दे आर अरेंज्ड इन क्लस्टर्स. बेसिलाई बैक्टीरिया स्टूडेंट्स, दीज आर रॉड शेप्ड बैक्टीरिया, एंड स्पायरोशीज मींस स्पाइरल शेप्ड, स्प्रिंग शेप लाइक. दीज आर थ्री मेन मॉर्फोलॉजिकल टाइप्स ऑफ बैक्टीरिया. नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू सेकेंड क्राइटेरिया, दैट इज स्टेनिंग टेक्निक. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द फील्ड ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी there are two widely accepted, most widely used staining techniques which are used to differentiate bacteria into different classes. Number one is Graham's staining technique. Graham's staining technique. Number two, ZN staining technique. Students, Graham's staining technique and ZN staining technique Actually, these two staining techniques are based on cell wall structures. And it is that because of differences in cell wall structures in different bacteria which have created Gram's staining and Zedel's staining techniques. Gram's staining technique divides bacteria into two main categories, Gram-positive bacteria and Gram-negative bacteria. Students, Gram-positive bacteria are those bacteria which appear violet color or bluish in color under the microscope. On the other hand, Gram-negative bacteria are those bacteria which appear reddish or pinkish in color under the microscope. Gram-positive bacteria, Staph aureus, most common bacteria in your syllabus. Gram-negative bacteria, E. coli. Okay, now Zedel staining technique. Students, Zedel is the abbreviation of Zeal-Nelson staining technique. It divides bacteria into two main categories, AFB positive bacteria and AFB negative bacteria. Students, AFB stands for acid fast bacillus, means those bacteria which show acid fastness in Zedel staining technique, and AFB negative bacteria which do not show acid fastness in Zedel staining technique. Now, AFB positive bacteria, Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Bacteria which is responsible for tuberculosis. AFB negative bacteria, Staph aureus. Okay students, this classification, this scenario is based on staining techniques. Now, number third scenario for the classification of bacteria. Nutrition. Nutrition. Students, on the basis of nutritional requirements, bacteria may be classified into autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotrophs are the bacteria which can assemble their sources of nutrition of their own or by using some other chemical agents. Students, autotrophic bacteria are those bacteria which can synthesize their food. On the other hand, heterotrophs are those bacteria which depend upon other organic matter for their nutritional requirements. Students, both autotrophs and heterotrophs, they are divided further into chemoautotrophs and photoautotrophs. Autotrophs, they are divided into further two categories, chemoautotrophs, photoautotrophs. Chemoautotrophs, these are the bacteria which uses chemical reactions as a source of their energy. Different chemical reactions which are going inside the body. Number two, photoautotrophs. Photoautotrophs, these are the bacteria which use sunlight as a source of energy. Okay? Now heterotrophs. Again students, heterotroph may be chemoheterotrophs and photoautotrophs. Photoheterotrophs. Now nutritional scenario have been discussed. Another scenario, students, heterotrophs have again been divided into three categories. Okay, saprophytes. Saprophytic bacteria. Okay, number two, parasitic bacteria. And number third, symbiotic bacteria. Students, saprophytic bacteria are those bacteria which consume dead organic matter as their source of energy. Okay, parasitic bacteria, they acquire their nutrition from the tissue of the host. And thirdly, symbiotic bacteria, students, this relationship between symbiotic bacteria and the host is beneficial. Both acquire benefit from one another. Now students, another criteria for classification of bacteria is anatomy. Students, there are different anatomical structures on the basis of which bacteria can be divided. For example, number one, capsule. Bacteria may be encapsulated, okay, as Streptococcus pneumonia. Bacteria may be encapsulated. For example, Streptococcus pneumonia. Bacteria may be without capsule, non-encapsulated. Okay, students? Viridans bacteria, Streptococcus viridans. Encapsulated, non-encapsulated. Second anatomical structure which classifies bacteria is flagella. Students, bacteria may be flagellated and bacteria may be non-flagellated. Third character, spore. Okay, bacteria may be spore forming as Bacillus bacteria, Bacillus anthracis, and bacteria may be non-spore forming bacteria, E. coli bacteria. So these are the three main anatomical features which classifies bacteria into different categories: capsule, flagella, and spore. Another criteria for classifying bacteria is culture. Students, as you know, culture is an artificial environment which is created for the growth of bacteria outside their normal habitat. Okay? And this artificial habitat, this artificial environment is created in the laboratory in petri dishes, in test tubes. And this artificial environment is called culture. Now, on the basis of culture, bacteria may be rapid growers. Okay, bacteria may be rapid growers such as Vibrio cholera. Bacteria may be slow growers, Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Bacteria may be rapid growers and slow growers. Another characteristic point is pigment production. Bacteria may be pigment producers. For example, Staph aureus, pigment producers. Staph aureus bacteria. Okay, and bacteria may be non-producer pigment. Pigment non-producers. Example is E. coli. Okay, students? Now, we move on to other criteria for the classification of bacteria. And this is temperature requirements, students. Temperature. On the basis of different temperature range, which favors the growth of bacteria, bacteria can be classified as psychrophiles. Psychrophiles bacteria. Okay, students? These are the bacteria which grows best at a temperature range below 20 degrees centigrade. Psychrophiles, mesophiles. Mesophiles bacteria, students. These are the bacteria which grow at a temperature range of 20 to 40 degrees centigrade. Okay? Thermophiles. Students, these are the bacteria which grow at a higher temperatures, above 40, above 50 degrees centigrade. Psychrophiles, mesophiles, and thermophiles. Now, students, another criteria for the classification of bacteria is oxygen requirement. On the basis of oxygen requirement, bacteria may be either aerobic bacteria or anaerobic bacteria. Aerobic bacteria, they require oxygen. And anaerobic bacteria, they do not require oxygen. Okay? Now, microaerophilic bacteria. Microaerophilic bacteria are those bacteria which grow at low oxygen concentrations. Microaerophilic bacteria, they grow at low oxygen requirements. Facultative anaerobes. Facultative anaerobes. Students, these bacteria grow either in the presence of oxygen or in the absence of oxygen. This was all about common scenarios of classification of bacteria. In my next lecture, I will be discussing with you different criterions for the identification of bacteria. Thank you, students. Allah Hafiz.